family. I am back. Wow, you see some time has been passed a little bit. Right now, it is 10:31 in the a.m. on the 23rd of April. And now we're going to talk about my yesterday at the festival, can we? Because I got shit to do now, okay? Because I've been talking all motherfucking morning on this Soulful Sunday session yet. You know what I mean? Not the fact that I'm trying to hurt anybody's feelings or telling anybody what to do, but just making you aware of the actions that, you know, and the repercussions. Just so that you're aware, I ain't no Dr. Phil or none of that old type of shit. I ain't Oprah or none of them motherfuckers. I'm just Tina from the motherfucking hood coming in, auntie trying to put you up on game and just saying, look, check this out. You reap what you sow. That's it. So we're going to push on. We're going to push forward because, nigga, I got to talk about this motherfucking what you call last night. First of all, I didn't get there until about 8 o'clock. Believe it or not, I didn't get there until about 8 o'clock. So whoever was performing, nigga, I didn't even see the motherfuckers, okay? Now, 50, yeah, I know 50 was there. I know Nas was there. But, look, check this out. I was on some whole other shit. I get there about 8-something, and I didn't have any credentials. Y'all already know that, but yet and still, I was given 2 wristbands. You got 1 pink wristband that was for general admission, which it was general admission. It was cool. It was free. Holla. So I had that, and I had my red one. The red one said medical marijuana. It had medical on there. So that one mean that, you know, on your way going in, they wanted to see what is called your rec. Let me get my wallet so I can show y'all what my card looked like. Hold on one second. Hold on. Hold on. Let me show you what the card looked like. Because, see, me... Okay, in the state of California, when... Because, see, marijuana was... cannabis, shall I say. Okayed for medicinal uses back, I believe, in 1996, and I believe that's where the 420 actually came from. A little bit of history on that right there. I know a motherfucker probably quote me, nah, it was in 97. Okay, but I believe it was in 96. And that's when, you know, it was passed in California to be able to use it via prescription from your physician for medicinal uses. And it was on the 420 on the ballot, or 420 day, or whatever. It was something significant to that 420, and that's what makes it a holiday for us. I say us because in another past life, I was also, as I began to go on my journey, I was also a hippie at once upon a time. I can totally relate to their get down. You know, I'm a live and let live individual. I'm on some old Zen shit. I'm like, if it feel good, keep on doing that. You know what I mean? I'm one of them motherfuckers. And I'm also very holistic. I'm very, very holistic. That's what allowed me to shed the weight that had, you know, riddled my life for so long. It wasn't until I began to start learning who I was and start going from within and start mending and fixing and, you know, myself internally, then therefore it began to show to everybody else. See, my weight was nothing more than a hard shell cover. You know what I'm saying? But I had to go from within and start washing out and cleaning out and, you know, taking out a lot of gunk and detoxing a whole bunch of things out of my life. And that's what brings me here. So this is just the outcome of what I've been working on internally for a long time. And so that's what's happening. And so, but throughout my path, I stumbled upon medicinal cannabis. My doctor prescribed it for me after I had lost my life in 2010 and regained it. At that point in time, I was on my share of medications. And so for the rest of my life, certain things that I would have had to take and all that stuff. I had full blood transfusions and all that kind of stuff. I literally lost my life. I have a whole nother birth date and all that. 5/5/10. Look it up. So with that, you know, I was in so much pain and they was giving me so much stuff and they was hitting me with steroids and all kinds of stuff. And one of my doctors was like, well, you know, just, I'm just gonna put this in your ear a little bit. You know, just think about it. This is just me and you talking. You know, you might want to start going holistic lifestyle. If you, you know, if this, I understand this is affecting my job and me going forward, but I like your spirit. You know, and he was the one of the first ones. Him, Mr. Malibu, introduced me to alkaline water full time. So he was also a vessel. My doctor was a vessel. And who else that started me on this path? I believe it really, really started from those two. Those are the two that I can really, you know, go to because, and I'll talk about the other part of a different thing. Right now, we're talking about the history of the 420 on how I see it and how I, this right here in my life. Well, so, so I didn't want to take all that shit anymore. You know, I was a zombie. I was fucked up. I was like, oh, hell no, I can't take this. So he's like, okay, well, then, you know, there is an alternative. You know, so he wrote me a script out. It give you a paper. It has to have a seal on it and all that other kind of stuff, you know, and it comes from your doctor. And then that is where you go to the dispensaries and different things and you pick up your medications. So also my doctor's office also had the hard card that also, and I got a gold seal on mine, but yeah. You also, I also ended up getting a hard card. And with this, I just simply take this, you know, to different places. It has my doctor's name on it, his telephone number, his license number, my information, my driver's license number. And you also have an ID that's sent to the state, an ID number and all that. This ain't no bullshit. You understand what I'm saying? Because motherfuckers get time for this. So this is not like they just giving this to everybody, you know what I'm saying? Which they do. But then once they get to running your numbers through the system, then therefore if your shit ain't right, oh, somebody going to be hollering at you from the state. You know what I mean? Because, yeah, once you start the process and then just like when you get your license to carry, you know, you have to put in to get your paperwork from the, you know, from the state or whatever. So now they know who's on what and who's getting what and who's licensed for what and who's, you know, able to roll with what. So with me, it's already in the system that, you know, I'm already one of these. You know what I mean? To whereas I'm not doing nothing illegal. I'm not nothing. This is, you know, my medicine for my life. You know what I mean? Not saying that, oh, to save my life. I'm not saying that shit. But I'm just saying that, you know, I'm on a holistic lifestyle. This is my everyday life. This is the way that I live. You know, I have an 80-20. I'm a fish eater. I eat all kinds of different meat, but I just, that's just not, you know, that's not readily on my palate. That's not something that I'm just looking to eat. That don't mean I don't eat it. It just means that I don't, you know, I don't wake up every day to just figure out what I'm going to eat for lunch, what I'm going to eat for dinner. Oh my God, I can't wait till I'm going to have lunch. There's times when I have to think about, damn, did I eat today? Did I eat at all? Or my kids would say, well, Mom, did you eat today? I just don't focus on food like that anymore. You know what I'm saying? Once I got rid of that aspect, that dependency in my life, then therefore it no longer serves me and it's not even a weakness anymore. Believe it or not, I don't have to take something to suppress my appetite. Whereas back in the day, nigga, I was a Fen-Phen motherfucker. Fen-Phen, Dexatrim, all them motherfuckers. Yeah, Zenical, all them motherfuckers. I was all of them, okay? Allie, all them motherfuckers. I took all that shit, okay? And it wasn't until I began to fix myself on why am I dependent and codependent on these things. What's going on in me? You know, and then I had to dissect some things. I began to hoard. I was a couponer, so I was hoarding stacks and stacks of this and stacks and stacks of that. And then shit, I was having weevils and all that shit. You know, because I was like, damn, I got a case of them motherfuckers for what? You know what I'm saying? So I started changing up a lot of things in my life. And one thing about my 420 card and or my medicinal card or however way anybody want to call it, my weed card, ganja, get down, whatever you want to call it. It also allows me to just think and just be on some zen. Okay? Now, there's indica, sativa, and there's a hybrid. Okay? Now, a sativa, I usually take that in the daytime. I usually, you know, and it's not the fact of, you know, motherfuckers just on some old rolling up zigzags and blunts and shit and just smoking weed on some old dumb shit. No, it's a lifestyle. It's not just no, oh, motherfuckers just getting high, just be, nigga, I'm just high, nigga, it's just high. No, that's dumb. You know, it's to me. You know what I'm saying? I can't connect with it like that. It allows me to think and slow down and get my creative juices flowing. And it allows me to think more of what I need to do and more for me to grow. It gives me incentive to do things. I don't focus on bad things. I focus on good things. This is what it do for me. Okay, now everybody is probably different, but for me, that's what an indica does for me. My sativa does for me. Now, when I take an indica, more of an indica, I do it at night. I got various things going from bongs to motherfucking dap or whatever, whichever way, or hookah, whatever, besides, you know, rappers. You know, so it's not the fact that, you know, but now that I'm more getting into a connoisseur type get down, now I'm getting more into elixirs and, you know, lotions, potions, and oils, and all that, salves and shit, you know what I'm saying, can of butter, and all that old type of shit. I'm going into that realm now. You know, with my clearance from the state, I'm able to grow my own get down, so whatever amount they told me that I was okay with, that's what I'm rolling with, you know what I mean? Yeah. So, and then with that, I'm about to go and harvest. I'm so excited for it, you know what I mean? I've been waiting all these motherfucking months, you know, but then, you know, as it's growing and you get to taste your crops and see what it, you know, where it's at and see what you need to add to it, what you need to get away from, you know. And me, I'm an earth sign, so I am grounded in that element. I'm grounded with the earth on, you know, working in my gardens and things of that. It's not the fact that I just have that. No, I got all kind of succulents and all kind of other different things as well as fruit and berries. But it's just the fact that I'm in such element. That works for me, you know. So that's when I say of the hippie type of get down, that's more so, that's my zen. That's where I feel most comfortable. That's part of my tribe. You know what I'm saying? That's like my aura or my vibration, my vibrational field or whatever you want to call it. You know what I mean? That's where I can feel like I can migrate and just be cool and comfortable and be myself. And allow you to do what you're going to do. I'm going to respect you, your views. I might not agree, but hey, guess what? You're grown, and if that works for you, then keep going with that. That's my personality. I'm not trying to be above or anybody or anything else. I'm not in that aspect. I've been there before, but where I'm at in my life right now, shit, I'm on the other half of my life. I'm trying to live and let live and have fun while doing it. That's where I'm at. Can I just be right there? That's where I'm at. So, that brings me to the festival. I was like, oh my God, I wanted to go so bad. I was like, I've never been before in my life. So I was like, oh my God, this motherfucker's coming to my city. And I ain't got no ticket, but I'm going anyway. Yeah. It was like, shit, this is the week of my daughter prime. I got to do all this right here, but I'm doing that. God showed me so much favor. I didn't have to pay to park. I didn't have to pay to get in. And all I spent was $40 the whole day. Everything else was free. Father God, I thank you, Lord. Everything was free. I got all kind of sacks and bags of shit. Huh? I got gifts and prizes, baby. Look, let me show you one motherfucking major arcana. Right here. This motherfucker right here. Huh? Oh, yes, yes, yes. Look at the roots and shit, too. Oh, my God. Oh my God, so after I get done with this, that's why I'm trying not to drag this too long, because I want to get out in my element, you know what I'm saying? I want to get out there and get grounded, and you know what I'm saying? Shit, I'll be holding conversations with my motherfucking trees. I'll be talking to them motherfuckers and having fun with them, yeah, looking at them grow, you know what I'm saying? Looking at because the leaves actually tremble and stuff at different times of the day, and I mean, I be at one with mine. I don't know. Everybody do their own. Everybody got their own shit that they into. Some motherfuckers watch porn. So, however way you get into your element while you watching porn, I get into that same shit and this motherfucking dirt over here. Okay? Same shit. There it is. The same way you feel when you take them motherfucking Vicodins and you like, oh, goddamn, I just want to sit right here. Okay, same thing I feel when I'm rolling around in these motherfucking earthworms and castings and the shit. Yeah, same way I feel. When the way you feel when you go down there, all you can eat spot, and you so motherfucking excited that you done bought a bag of Ziplocs with you. Same way I feel when I'm out there and I'm picking in the leaves and pulling out the weeds and all that old type of shit. Same way I feel. Same thing. So, that's just what I like. Everybody like what they like. And so, in me and my little hippie lifestyle, this is what I like. And I'm not made up all the time. I'm always dialed down. You know, but there's times when I got to get up and get some clothes on. You know, and yesterday was such a time, and when I tell you I had a good time, I stood up here, I made about, I would say on my motherfucking iPad, I got at least 10 motherfucking, nah, not 10, between 5 and 7 videos that I did, different songs that was just, I just got, you know what, I just found out about Pandora. Don't laugh at me. Real, true story. I just found out about Pandora. Isaiah put me up on it about a couple of nights ago when I was making my daughter's prom dress. So Thursday night was the first time I'd ever put Pandora on my motherfucking phone, either any phone I had. Nigga, I felt like I had, oh my God, look, it was Christmas. I was just in disbelief, like, oh my God, this shit just keep coming on one after another. Now, I do know that my friend had, he would hook his phone up and his phone would have different stuff was coming on, but I never really asked no questions about. You know, I thought that was maybe something that was just on his phone or whatever. I never really asked no questions. But, man, now, man, I was like, oh, my God, this is incredible. And then I was able to put in Anthony Hamilton and all kind of shit. The guy was getting Jaheim, Avon, all kind of, man, oh, my God, it was just incredible. So, shit, I put my motherfucking what you call it on, nigga, and I'm on some whole other Zen shit, nigga. And I'm about to get out in this dirt. I'm so excited for it. So, anyway, got down there, no credentials, but I was blessed with all that. Came in, and they inside one of the convention halls is where, oh my God, inside the video, you're going to see that I'm in there. And I'm like, man, it was all kinds of shit. I mean, everything about this life, it was just, oh my God, I was like sensory overload. Like, for real, are you kidding? Like, is this crazy? And, oh, my God, it was like so much of, do you want a dab? Do you want a blunt? Do you want a pre-roll? Do you want a this? Do you want a this? It's free. Don't you worry about it, pretty lady. It's free. You know what I'm saying? And, oh, my God, it was cool. But, see, one thing you got to understand, regular weed ain't regular weed no motherfucking mo. And you got to also understand and know who rolled that motherfucking shit up. You understand what I'm saying? So then, therefore, I ain't after getting everybody's daps, and I ain't after just getting everybody on this and that. But however, though, if you got a business, then therefore, and you're in an establishment, then therefore, I got a place to come to in case it's a problem. But if it's just in the wide open right here, and everybody doing their thing, and motherfuckers is telling you, oh, well, hit this right here, and you don't know what the fuck you hitting, oh, my God, I don't know. You know what I'm saying? Your motherfucking ass be biting at the wind. So I'm like, and I'm by myself too, so I was just a little bit hesitant about different things. But I was given some pre-rolls and shit. Man, I fucked around and fucked with that motherfucker. It was so goddamn unethical. I said, oh my God, nigga, for real? What's going on? It seemed like everything began to close in on itself. I was like, oh my God, get off my arm. And wasn't nobody touching me or nothing, but it just seemed like everything was closing in on my ass. I said, oh my God, what's going on? I hope I ain't gonna fade into black, nigga. I was worried like a motherfucker. That shit had me tripping out. I was like, oh shit, don't nobody come in here, please. Nigga, I got low-key paranoid and all kind of shit. I was like, somebody else, who rolled the weed on this shit? Him. But oh my God, that motherfucker is so cold-blooded. I said, oh shit, for real? For real? So, and then, but then all where you go to all the different booths or whatever, if you wanted a dap, if you wanted a pre-roll, if you wanted this, if you wanted that, they were almost like giving it away. It was like nothing. It was just free. Just here. Take our cars. Take our this. You know what I'm saying? And man, and it was a hippie love affair. Everybody was on some live and let live and not fucking tripping. Ain't nobody judging nobody. Everybody just partying, getting fucked up, laid out. You gonna see so many motherfuckers laid out with their tongue out. Motherfuckers laid out just in the middle of shit. Just laid the fuck out like, nigga, good night, nigga. Yeah, I mean, it was just cool. The aura, I was like, oh my God, what's going on, nigga? This is my habitat like a motherfucker. Ain't nobody tripping. Ain't nobody got time to fight nobody. Shit, motherfuckers was in slow motion. Them niggas was playing Street Fighter, Mortal Kombat, and all that shit. They had like these motherfucking big screens, right? on one side, whereas motherfuckers was playing Madden and all kind of different, man, motherfuckers was just, man, it was chill. I mean, it was huge. They had a Ferris wheel. Just, man, it was cool. So it was like, you know, I was taping different things, you know, and stuff. And I was just fucking with the one get down that I had. But I still know that I had to keep my wits about myself because I'm like, shit, nigga, I'm by myself. Don't know these motherfuckers. You know what I mean? You don't know what the fuck. You know what I mean? You got to be on top of what's happening. I hit that motherfucker one time. I said, oh, my God, wait a minute. Hold on. Shit, nigga, if you don't back up off me. Shit, I was like, oh my God, I was like, oh shit, hold on, nigga, I said, I'm finna sit down over here for a minute, cause I'm good, I'ma just sit down right here, don't fuck with me, you know what I mean, and I'm just gonna watch these motherfuckers walk by. You gonna be seeing motherfuckers just sitting down, just sitting in corners like, man, shit, I don't know, I don't even know which way I'm supposed to go. I came with somebody, I done forgot who that was. These motherfuckers was just on some Space Ghost, niggas was fucked up. I was like, oh my God. It was on a whole different level. It was so cool. So, I mean, I got a little bit of footage, you know, different little cool shit about it, man. But, man, so, and one of my, what you call, the thing that I was given, and of course I'm not going to show that just out of respect for some people really got a problem. I know I showed the other little, this right here, because I spent 20 on this. And, oh my God. This motherfucker's a couple ones. This motherfucker right here is something else. Do you understand me? I said, oh my God, nigga, you are something else. Oh my God, thank you. Oh my God, thank you. $20. This is one of the coolest $20 I spent in a long goddamn time. For real? 20? 20, twin, twin. Twin? Oh my God. This twin here, nigga, this dub was one of the best dub. Nigga, listen, I love you, okay? We are going to be good friends, honey. We're going to get through some things together. Do you understand how creative we going to be? Oh, my God. Y'all need to thank this motherfucker. This motherfucker, he is cold-blooded. I just love you, and I just want you to know that you will be destroyed. But, oh, my God, I thank you. This motherfucker right here was $20, 20. I done already, you know what I'm saying, got some prepared. And I done already, you know what I'm saying, that's why I'm on what I'm on right now. This motherfucker here. This, $20. The motherfucking unethical was in this motherfucker right here, okay? And oh my God, it filled this bitch up. That's how thick it was, and that's the length of it, okay? So I just had to fuck with it just because I was like, man, it was rolled up all tight, nigga. That was worth at least 4 motherfucking zigzags, you know what I'm saying? That motherfucker was rolled tight, and like they just slid right in this motherfucker like a sleeve. So it was so pretty, motherfucker. What can I do? It's like, oh my God, hello, hi. Oh my God, for real? For real. You know what I mean? I had to fuck with it just to see, you know what I mean? So I was like, okay. So, but this motherfucker right here. And then it was so many people had their different edibles. And this right here is just like a granola. And I had put it in here, but it's good as fuck. Oh my God, it's some granola. Some niggas had barbecue. I was like, oh my God. Nigga, they had the barbecue sauce on the twist. That shit was so motherfucking flame. I was like, nigga, it's for real? It was like, shit, we can do baked beans and everything. Shit, it's nothing. We know how to do this and everything we doing. I was like, oh my God. Nigga, that motherfucker gave me a card and everything. He was like, you know what? Let me give you a card, please. Can I give you a card? Okay, this is the shop number. This is my telephone number right here that I carry my phone on me. This right here, this is my mama number in case you need to find me, in case you don't get me on them two. I need you to call me. Yeah, that motherfucker was straight 100, but he was like, look, you came to this motherfucker by yourself. I'm just, wait a minute, hold on. You came by yourself? For real? Now, I already know that this indica and shit is working on me something serious. But for real, you came by yourself. Okay, look, let me give you a series of numbers. Whereas you can't say that you can't get a hold of me. That motherfucker was just that goddamn serious. I mean, I'm being a funny. You know what I'm saying? And I'm putting a 10 on the 2. But just about. You know what I mean? He was like, see, that motherfucker gave me like 3 goddamn numbers and shit. And so, at any rate, baby, when I tell you, oh my God, that motherfucking barbecue was superb, okay? That motherfucking barbecue was superb. And in the video, I believe I did a portion of it. I think I showed y'all, and I was fucking with the barbecue. They had and you could just go up there and get an hors d'oeuvre of the hot links or whatever. okay? So they had like a catering truck that you could buy, and then, but they also had a little thing where you can just go up and, you know, they had all kind of different other things, like you can, you know, they had the catering truck where you can buy hot food, and then they had the other little thing on the side where you could just buy, you know, different cannabis and different things that they had. Man, I was like, look at the, and they was black. I was like, y'all motherfuckers ain't bullshit. They was like, oh yeah, we do this and all this. We do this and all this. I was like, oh wow. I was like, okay. Didn't I tell you something about assimilation? Didn't I tell you vibe and tribe? Yeah. So, family. And then, like, a couple of things down, they had, this guy had this right here. And this was pretty damn good. This one motherfucker had, he had put a twist on some old pretzel. You know, what do you call that shit? Trail mix? Yeah, trail mix. Because it had pretzels, peanuts, some other shit. And nigga, that shit was good. It was $5. Man, I didn't buy none, no. I only spent $40, cheap ass. I spent $40 and the rest of my shit I got free. And I ain't mad at it. Because I was talking to this one cat. Hold on, let me show you. And we just talking, you know what I'm saying? And I was telling him that I had, you know, bought me a little plant. That's a CBD plant. Remember I was telling you guys about CBD. CBD is awesome. It's a, more of a holistic, you know, more medicinal. When you really, really want to go the real thick medicinal route, then you would also, rotate a little CBD in with your THC. Because your THC is what everybody else is on. That's like the main thing. Indica, sativa, hybrid, all of those are, you know, pretty much THC heavy. Then the flip to THC is CBD is the opposite of that. And that one is giving you more medicinal properties. But the thing is with that is you don't set no flame to it. So that's where you're going to put that, like I'm going to use that and I'm going to extract oils from it. So being that I'm going to grow my own, I'm going to have use an ounce of my own to create the oil. And then it'll give me a jar of something like that. You know what I'm saying? A whole ounce. So I'm growing that to do other different things to it, not just on some inhaling type shit, which I will do that as well because, you know, one tree will yield you up to 2 pounds. You know what I'm saying? It just depends on the yield of that particular strain. But yeah, you definitely, you know, especially if you do it right, you know, you get your soil tester, stay on top of things. The main things is nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. If those are level in the pH balance, you guys always know I'm talking about pH balance. I'm always talking about acidic and alkaline. And in this and in when you're dealing with agricultural type stuff and nursery stuff and working in the gardening and all that stuff, your pH balance means a lot. And that's letting you know if your plants or your foliage is going through distress or not. And, you know, it will show on the leaves and all those different things because you just don't give things water. You also have to nurture them with food. You can't live on water alone. At some point in time, you got to eat some food, right? Okay, well, the same thing is with anything that grows, be it an animal or whatever. You just can't give them the same thing the rest of their life. Do you want the same thing the rest of your life? How are you going to be? You know, you're not going to be right. So you got to have nourishment besides just water. You know, you have to have a variety. And in that same thing, I also give the different things to make it do. If you want it more potent, if you want it more sweet, if you want it more cakey, if you want different hues to it, different things, you can add different additives throughout the cycle of its growth. At certain times, you can give it certain things to make it do what you want it to do. But now that I've become a connoisseur, I know, you know what I'm saying, I'm on my get down. Anyway, I was talking to this guy, and he blessed me with this. Straight gave me a whole bottle. and it's pertaining to the grove. It's called Skunk Works, all-in-one, ultra-concentrated plant food. So, yeah, he gave me this right here, straight. And it's a balance of nitrogen is 4, phosphorus is 3, and potassium is 5. So it's somewhat balanced. So I don't know. I'm gonna have to really look at it and, you know, and see. And this was somebody that was just walking around. He was like, you know, we was talking about the actually I was watching him play Street Fighter and shit. And so, and him and I was just standing up, we was just talking, and I was telling him that I had bought a tree and all this kinds of stuff. And he was like, well, here, I got something for you. And I was like, for real? Motherfucker straight gave it to me. So, but he was saying that he grow and shit too. He was saying that he's about that life. So, didn't I tell you how your vibe gonna, you know, call on your tribe? Yeah. Yeah, and it was like, I put a little bit of it in the video. It was like, shit, you know, he just blessed me with it. And I was like, man, let me put your ass on what you call it and shit. He was like, yeah, cool, no problem. And I was like, and he just gave it to me, you know, just in the midst of us just talking. I didn't ask him for anything or nothing. It was like, well, you know what, I got something for you. And I was like, really? And I was like, okay, I will take it because, you know, I do grow too. So I was like, man, he was like, no, here, I want you to have it. Really, have it. I was like, oh my God. So I was blessed with this. I don't know how good it worked or nothing to the kind, but yeah. And so, but in here, I got different, you know, little tokens and different things. You know, they, you know, different little places give you different things, different pamphlets. And I mean, yes, I got this. So much of this shit that I'm just gonna, you know, look at it at my own time. Business cards, motherfuckers was just giving me business cards and stuff. So, man, I had a really, really, really good time. Yes, 50 Cent was there. The game, I missed all of that, so I don't know. I don't know. I can't speak on what I don't know. Nas was there, yes. And it was jam packed. Man, it was so many motherfuckers up there getting. Blow these brothers, and I put it on the video on the thing too. They had bought this weed, they had it already all crunched up and everything. How about the motherfucker drop the weed on the ground? Nigga, them motherfuckers had the flashlight. I had to put that shit on motherfucker, what you call it? The motherfucker had dropped the weed. I was like, nigga, how you drop the weed though? Oh my God, and everybody, because fuck that, how come he didn't sit down though with it? So I don't know how much of it that he dropped, but shit, and it was dark too, nigga. They had their flashlights on their phones, nigga, trying to get it all up. I was like, nah, y'all motherfuckers getting ready to be smoking on glass and motherfuckers done spit on the ground and all kinds of shit, nigga. That's over with. Cut that shit loose. Whatever that was some money that was just gone now. That's over with. Leave that shit alone. I wouldn't even want to get in a rotation on that shit now, nigga. You glass and all kinds of shit all in there. All kind of dead-ass flies and ants and shit, man. Fuck that. I'm cool. You know what I'm saying? If it was me, if I was in that circle, because they had their women and shit with them. I think it was one or two chicks was with them. But y'all gonna see it on there, because I put it on there. So I'm gonna take my time and edit all that out. But man, it was just, man, it was cool, man. The simulation was cold. The conversations, you know, the networking about this life. It's really deep, you know, it's really, really motherfucking deep, and it's, you know, people you wouldn't even think, you know, motherfuckers is just thinking that this is just niggas just smoking weed on corners and selling dime bags and nickels and shit. No, nigga, this is some serious lifestyle shit, and this motherfucker's really coined on this right here. Shit, don't fuck with Game, because that nigga makes like close to a meal ticket a month. He has one of the coldest dispensaries in Orange County. Look it up. I'm not bullshitting you. That motherfucker done got all kind of awards and all that. So he take his money. He be Peter Panning and shit and doing shit for, I think, Robin Hood. He be on some, excuse me, I don't mean Peter Pan because I know a lot of people don't really Peter Pan shit. That motherfucker's dark. But yeah, on some Robin Hood shit, yeah, the game, he's more to just, you know, this is, you know, on some old blood shit. Yeah, he's more to it than that. The cat is cool on a whole different motherfucking level. And on a business level, the nigga got one of the coldest motherfucking dispensaries. That nigga got drinks and everything, okay? He got everything, okay? So, yeah, it's a lifestyle. It's not the fact that, you know, motherfuckers is just doing this thing. Because it's motherfuckers you do not believe. You be like, oh, I don't know, she's my weed. Shit, yeah. A lot of motherfuckers move from different places, move to California, because California is just liberal that way. You know, it's live and let live, nigga. Shit, let me get out your way, nigga. Do your thing. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So, at any rate, it was a good night. I came home. Well, I left. I went to McDonald's. Got me some chicken nuggets, as you will see. And then I went and picked up my daughter. Because I knew I was gonna probably be out, so I picked her up because I knew I needed her back at a certain time. Ain't gonna be no after party and after the after and the after after. Nah, none of that shit. Not and especially I see who you with. Nah, we gonna make this sweet and sweet. I mean, short and sweet. Now if y'all wanna go eat, no problem. Miss Tina gonna take y'all, but nah, ain't you not gonna drive tonight and none of that right there. So it turned out to be really, really nice. And then they wanted to go to IHOP. They went to IHOP. I took them there and I told them, I said, you guys call me when y'all ready. So they called me about 1:20. I went and picked them up. I took him home and me and her came home and that's how my night pretty much ended. But yesterday was an awesome day. Awesome day. Met some really, really cool people. Exchanged some numbers with some real cool people. You know what I'm saying? So, I'm building my tribe. I'm just, man, I'm having fun. Shit. I'm starting to get back into the groove of having fun. I don't want to just say some shit that I'm really not there yet. You know what I'm saying? To be perfectly honest with you, I'm working towards that. You know what I mean? I've had some disappointments, so I'm trying to work through those disappointments and all that stuff. I'm just a girl. I'm just a girl. I'm just a girl with real feelings that, my mouth is toe out. I talk like a sailor, but that's just my defense mechanism sometimes. And that's just, my verbiage. That's just how I get down. You know what I'm saying? People say what they say or, whatever. So anyway, I'm gone. Had a good time. I'm getting ready to go put this girl in some, and when you start off your clones, because it's considered as a clone. When you start off your clone, you want to buy what is called Foxform C4s. Foxform is the company name, and C4s is the soil name. And it is full of, it's balanced, and it also has worm castings in it. It has seaweed and all the good stuff to give this a really good start. So I'm really so excited about bringing this into my family, of all these guys. And so, man, so I'm just getting ready to get in my element right now. I'm gonna put me on some shorts and a little tank top, no bra, no panties. And I'm getting ready to just be outside and doing me and put my feet in the dirt. How about that? A little grounding. Why not? Love you guys. Love you guys for watching. You guys have a good day. Love you. Bye-bye.